India, a country famous for its rich culture and history. It's famous for its fast food and the Taj Mahal. It's famous for its politics. Something else it is famous for? The movie industry. In India, more than 1800 movies are produced annually. Major centers of film production in the country include Mumbai, Chennai, Hyderabad, Kolkata, Kochi, and Bangalore. For a number of years, the Indian film industry has ranked first in the world in terms of annual film output. In terms of box office, it ranked third in 2019. With a total gross of around $2.7 billion. Indian cinema is a global enterprise, and the films have wide viewership and fan base throughout South Asia as well as over 90 countries. But our movie industry wasn't as big as today as it was about 100 years ago. Let's deep dive into the history of our glorious Indian cinema. The history of Indian cinema in India extends back to the beginning of the film era. Following the screening of the Lumiere and Robert Paul moving pictures in London in 1896, commercial cinematography became a worldwide sensation. And by mid-1896, both Lumiere and Robert Paul films had been shown in Bombay. Just like European and American cinema, we also began by the production of silent films and then what we call talkies. Let's look at the humble origins of our movie industry and the great Dada Saheb Phalke. The first Indian film released in India was Shri Pundalik, a silent film in Marathi, but it is arguable because it was a video recording of the play and it was processed in Great Britain and filmed by a British cameraman. So the throne of the first Indian movie goes to Raja Harishchandra. Directed and written and produced by the father of Indian cinema, the late great Dada Saheb Phalke. Now we move into the 1930s where India started producing talkies. Talkies, or a sound film, is a motion picture with synchronized sound or sound technologically coupled to image, as opposed to the previous silent films. Ardashir Irani released Alam Ara, the first Indian talkie, on March 14, 1931. Irani later produced the first South Indian talkie film, Kalidas, directed by H.M. Reddy, which was released on 31st October of 1931. Jamai Shoshti was the first Bengali talkie. Chittor V. Nagaya was one of the first multilingual actor, singer, composer, producer, and directors in India. He was known as India's Paul Mooney. Now that we know how motion pictures was introduced in our country, let's move on to what is known as the Golden Age of Indian Cinema. The period from the late 1940s to the early 1960s is regarded by film historians as the Golden Age of Indian Cinema. This period saw the emergence of the parallel cinema movement, which was spearheaded by Bengalis, which then accounted for a quarter of India's film output. The movement emphasized social realism. When talking about the Golden Age, we cannot not talk about the great Satyajit Ray. When discussing about Satyajit Ray, I got someone to help me. A friend of mine will take over. He's an aspiring actor who knows a lot about Bengali films, especially Ray.
Satyajit Ray. Satyajit Ray is an enigma. So for the first time, when I watched Kupika in Bhagavan, I really loved it. But then when I grew up, and then again when I went through Kupika in Bhagavan, it was totally a different experience, because there is an underlying political message was there. Yeah, it was sugarcoat, but he wanted to tell something. Plus, all of his movies are like totally mesmerizing. He is not only the greatest filmmaker in India, he is one of the greatest filmmakers in the world also. Plus, he has inspired a lot of famous filmmakers, from Christopher Nolan to Martin Scorsese and many more. Plus, Wes Anderson was also there. And he is the one and only Indian director who has got an honorary Oscar.
The Oppu trilogy by Satyajit Ray won major prizes at all the major international film festivals and firmly established the parallel cinema movement. Pother Panchali from 1955 was the first part of the trilogy and marked Ray's entry in Indian cinema. The trilogy's influence on world cinema can be felt in the youthful coming-of-age dramas that flooded art houses since the mid-50s, which owe a tremendous debt to the Oppu trilogy.
When we are talking about Satyajit Ray, I think we should talk about his first film, Pother Panchali. Yeah, it's the best Indian movie you can ever see. Like, it also won Cannes Film Festival Award and Best Human Documentary. I think every director and actress should watch it.
Dilip Kumar debuted in the 1940s and rose to fame in the 1950s and was the biggest Indian movie star of the time. He was a pioneer of method acting, predating Hollywood method actors such as the Godfather himself, Marlon Brando. Much like Brando's influence on new Hollywood actors, Dilip Kumar inspired Indian actors including Amitabh Bachchan, Nasiruddin Shah, Shah Rukh Khan and Nawazuddin Siddiqui. From the 70s, 80s, 90s and now to the 2000s, the term Bollywood was coined when the conventions of commercial Bollywood films were established. Now, we come to know about what we know of the modern day Bollywood industry. Commercial Hindi cinema grew in the 1980s with films such as Ek Dooje Ke Liye, Disco Dancer, Himmat Wala, Tohfa, Naam, Mr. India and Tezab. By 1986, India's annual film output had increased from 741 films produced annually to 833 films, making India the world's largest film producer. Since the 1990s, the three biggest Bollywood movie stars have been the three Khans, Aamir, Shah Rukh and of course Salman. Combined, they starred in the top 10 highest grossing Bollywood films. The three Khans have had successful careers since the late 1980s and have dominated the Indian box office since the 1990s. Shah Rukh Khan was the most successful of most of the 1990s and 2000s, while Aamir Khan has been the most successful since the late 2000s.
So previously in the Hindi film industry, it was more about star driven, means a star will carry the film forward, but now the story is the star. It's more about story driven. It's more about this concept, and it changed after 2000, early 2000 or 2001 when Farhan Akhtar first made Dil Chahta Hai, it totally changed the Indian cinema. And after that, many new filmmakers came, like from Anurag Kashyap to Himanshu Dhulia, Imtiaz Ali, many famous filmmakers came. And they changed the Indian, I will not say Hindi film industry, I will rather say Indian film industry. And their focus is mainly on the script, not on the stars. So in modern Bollywood or the Hindi films, it's more about the story. Story is the main star, and it's not about who will play the lead character or that.
The time has passed when Hindi-speaking industry or Bollywood represented Indian cinema. The regional uprising had begun.
So, who's your favorite South Indian actor?
Allu Arjun.
Allu Arjun.
Yes. Pushpa naam sunke flower samjhe kya? Flower nahi. Fire.
Previously, South Indian movies were mindless action and comedy, but nowadays it's all about Indian film industry.
The South Indian movies, namely the Tamil and Telugu industry, began a revolution in our industry. Now, with the rise of OTT platforms such as Netflix, Amazon, and many more throughout the country, these movies are possible for everyone to see. The movie theaters are not the only option.
So previously what we used to do is like, we used to ask our friends like, did you see that Shah Rukh movie or did you see that Salman movie or other stars movie that are releasing, Bollywood stars movies, so-called Bollywood stars movies. But now it is not only about Bollywood, it is about the Indian cinema, because the regional film industries has grown quite a lot, and so we are all the Indian film lovers or movie lovers are watching the regional movies as well, like our South industry, Marathi film industry. So Indian film industry is going.
From Dada Saheb Phalke to Satyajit Ray and now to Anurag Kashyap and more, we have learned how we began as a movie industry and now have occupied most of the movies in the world. Today, we learned that India can only go upwards from here. It can't be stopped. And now that the OTT platforms have also been in the scene, we are just getting started. It seems that India will not be stopped in this field also. So that was the history of Indian cinema.